Hi everyone, this is Kevin from Sticks and Stones Wood Carving. Today I'm going to do a little bit more of a wood spirit type pattern. A lot of people are learning wood spirits from me on the channel. And what I'd like to do is give you something that's a little more interesting but still very basic, okay? To give you an idea of some dimensions of faces and everything. We're going to do a mountain man. And the mountain man, what makes him interesting is you can accessorize them. Right? You can put a necklace on them. They're great for doing in cottonwood bark, stuff like that. And what I was thinking of trying today is giving you a basic drawing or coming up with a basic pattern and show you how to draw it where you can make a mountain man with a wolf head on him. You know, the wolf head cape that they wear over their head as protection from the weather, all right, and the elements. So let's see what we can come up with here. I know my shadow's in the way, but I think we're... with a pretty decent marker, you'll be able to see this okay. Let me just see. About up in here, I'm going to need a dot so I know that I'm in range. And about down to here, I guess I can go. So I got to keep them in between there. Okay. All right. So what we're going to do is we're going to come up to the top here. I'm going to figure out my dimensions. I think I'm going to start. I don't even leave enough room for a wolf head. So right about here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to make kind of like a V. Okay? See that V? Right. Then from there, I can figure out where I want, you know, like the bottom of his face and everything. All right, so right from there, we're going to take one line and two lines. Just like that. They're kind of curved. All right. They don't have to be perfect. And coming right down from those lines, I'm going to come down and come down. Make those lines symmetrical. We're going to go out in a little bit of a curve. Give a little bit of a curve down. And a little bit of a curve on the other side. All right, for the nose. All right, still keeping it real simple. All right, from there, we're going to go to a mustache. And I'm just going to kind of make a fairly small, not too large, all right, mustache on this guy. Because I don't want to make him super, super fancy, but I don't want to make him too serious either for beginner drawers, all right. Now from there, we're going to give him a little bit of a lip. Like that, all right. We're going to use the top part as the wolf head, okay? We have our dimensions for our face here. So on the top, what I'm going to do is right above this V here, I'm going to draw kind of like a triangle that's upside down for a nose. And that's going to be the wolf's nose. Now I'm going to color that in so it stands out for you guys. Okay. That will be our wolf's nose. Not far up from that, all right, I'm going to draw two slits. One, two. Okay. Then a V, kind of a rounded V, all right, because you've got to remember this is on his head, so his head, this is going to be kind of flattened out. It's not a real high head on the wolf, all right. And after that B over here, we're going to give, you know, kind of like an ear. And on this side over here, we're going to have an ear. Remember, this wolf head is caped out. He doesn't have all his parts. Okay. So these are just going to be slits. Right? Then we can gauge what we want to do with the top after we start putting more dimensions in on the face. And I want to figure out the dimensions of my face, how I want this guy to be. So I'm going to bring these over a little. I'm going to come down from here and bring that in like that. Same on this side. I'm going to try and make it kind of symmetrical as far as shape goes. And like that. Okay. Now I can make the beard as big as I want. Might even shorten it a little bit to get a better mountain man here, okay? I'm going to do something like that. That simulates hair, guys. Okay. So, he's looking pretty good. I'm liking that. All right, so now I'm going to take this line here, the very first V that we drew, and I'm going to connect that. All right, so I'm going to come down with it. Just like that. I'm going to take the, pick it up over here. See where it is right here? Going up to the wolf's nose. And I'm going to, just trying to keep my beard fairly shaped the same on both sides. And the outside over here, we're going to round the wolf's head off a little bit. All right. You can hear my bird dog growl, howling up there. He misses me. Don't mind him if you hear him on the camera. When I leave, he tends to have a little bit of a hissy fit. All right. He's starting to shape up pretty good. So now all I'm going to do is I'm going to run that down. You know. And there's his cape. All right. He's caped out. Fully covering his head. All right. Come in a little bit. Draw one line, another line here, all right, these will go up, and we're going to pick up another, we're going to make another V, like that, and this right here can be, I don't know, a little piece of leather, or something to hang a medallion off of, okay? And then, of course, this right here could actually come. I could make all this hair here. And even come in this way. When I start filling it in, you'll see. Okay. And we just make that, you know, real light. This would be hair. Okay. Just a bunch of little carved lines if we're doing the carving. This would just be lines. And we can adjust the hair any way we want. I'm just going to color a little for now. So once I have my dimensions in there. I want to make it wider or whatever. And this right here would just be the cape. Of his cape. Right. And of course the mustache and beard and all that would be, you know, this would all be filled in with gouge marks and V cuts. Right. And this is his neck. Now above that line, by the nose here, see these two lines for the eyes? That's where you would start to carve an eyebrow. Okay, it would kind of go out like that. Give him a couple of wrinkles here for some character, and then you can put eyes on him. But this right here, again, is the top part of his eyebrows, but it's eyebrows. Okay, on the bottom we would have to put his eyelids. That's where people get confused. All right, you have to have a top and lower eyelid. Okay, and then we would carve the eyes, and when we do the eyes, that's better left for a carving video. You don't really need them when you're doing a drawing, all right, for a pattern, because you're just going to carve them out anyway. But that right there is our basic mountain man. We could put a little tooth or something on his necklace, whatever, I don't know, whatever you want to do, you know. But that right there is pretty basic. You can make this longer, you can make it wider, any way that he looks good to you, okay? Just kind of play with it. I do most of my playing with my carving tools, not so much drawing. I like to get a basic outline, and then I go from there, and then I fix everything with carving tools. So that's a basic way to make a nice little mountain man, all right, with a wolf cape on him. So I hope that helped. Hope it gave you an idea how to do a couple other faces, all right? And I will see you for another drawing. And we'll start carving some of these projects in a bit. But we're going to stick with trying to get you guys to draw your own patterns to show you that it's really not that hard to come up with an idea once you know a couple of basic shapes to do faces in. All right. So, good luck trying them. If you want to, trace them on the wood, cut them out, and use that pattern all you want, any way you want. Carve it, paint it, sell it. I don't care. It's all about learning and you guys getting better. Thanks again. If you liked the video, like it. You know, if you have any suggestions for other drawings or carvings, please let me know. Shoot me a message. Feel free to comment. See you next vid.